Okay, so from the beginning when we started, we said when you load the background, you can change the color of the background. And then when you want the background, you can go to Google for your background that you want to use. And then I also introduced a website called freepics.com. Please see the name, Freepics. The pics is PIK.com. Okay, freepics.com. If you don't know, you type a wrong name, they will take you to a site you will not like. It happens to me. Okay, so you have backgrounds and elements that you can download from here. And I mentioned that as part of our next week, I'll be showing you how you can download some of these elements to use in your design. You don't have to do some of them from scratch. Okay, so if I type logo, they'll give me a lot of logos. So if I like any of them, I can pick them and go and manipulate it to create my logos. Okay, so I will show you. That's why I'm saying that I will show you in Illustrator. So you can see the logos that they have here. Okay, so yeah, they are going to show you a lot of logos. So if you want any of them and you want to manipulate it, you can go in for it, and then you go and work on it. So there are a lot of work projects that are here. Some of them you pay for them. So if you have money, you can be paid for them if it's a business you are doing, because it's like $9 a month. Okay, these are flyers. So you have a lot of sample flyers that you can use. And it's not only Illustrator's project that are here. You can go in to look for project that are PSD is a Photoshop file. So when I select the resources that are Photoshop, yeah, then I search for Photoshop files. Okay, so yeah, these are Photoshop projects. So for example, if I want to use this, I'll just go in. Now, I mentioned that when you see the orange, it means you have to pay. So let me show you something. I have an account with them, so I will try and log in to see if I can download it. Okay, so we are not here for that today. We'll do that next week. So you download your image, okay? The image that you want, you look for it, and then you can download it. But if you want quality image, then you have to go to that website to download it, and then they will be able to give you image. Okay. Let me see if I have some. Okay, so these are some backgrounds that I have downloaded recently. Okay, so I downloaded this. So, and I said that if you want to change the color of this, you just, so that's why adjustment layers. So adjustment layer will have effect on the layer panel. So I go into hue and saturation. Then I'll use the hue. The saturation is just going to increase the color to make it more deep. Okay, you can see it. So I will use the hue to change the color. Okay, so if it's this color I want, I will do it, and then yeah. So you can see it. Yeah. Then it will affect only the background unless I have something under it. Let me pick this. So this is going to be on top of the adjustment layer. So you see that it doesn't have any effect on it. But if I were to bring it down, that's where arrangement matters. I bring it down, see, it changes the color of that background. Okay. And then I also mentioned that if it has to do with pictures. Okay. So like the one we have here. So I have the pictures. I selected the top one, then I go into the adjustment, hue and saturation. Then I can change. Remember, it's affecting all of them. But what if I want it to affect only the top one? Okay. I'll have to select these two here. That is going to have effect on what is below. Okay. So I click on it and then it brings it down. So it means whatever effect I'm going to do, the color and all that will have effect on only that picture within the layer panel. Okay. So that's how you use it. If it's the background, I'll just push this to be on the background. And because background is the last thing down there, It can affect the background. I don't have to really care unless I want to do another one. So let me go to black and white. And I want the. Okay. So I want the black and white to affect only the top picture. Okay. So you can see it's only affecting this one. Okay. So you have different of the adjustment layers that you can use. Yeah. So when you have time, practice them. I mentioned that the curves can be used to make the thing darker or brighter. So if your image is too dark, you can just push it up. You just click at the middle here. You see here on this point, and then you push it up, and then you bring it down. Okay. If you click at another place, you may be doing something else. For example, if I click at this and push it, you see that it's having effect in the internal image. You see that the contrast is coming from the down. Okay. So you can see it's affecting the edge of the image. But if I were to hold the middle, you see that it has a uniform effect on it. So you have to practice how you want to use it. So that's how you change the color of this. So that is with the adjustment layers. So we have, yeah, quite a number of them that you can practice. But I can assure you, when you are doing graphic design, the hue and saturation will be the probably the only thing you'll be using, and then the curves and levels. Okay, level is also like the curve. When you come in, you make your background. So yeah. Now let's go to the effects. That is the blending options. The blending option works with any other object. Okay, but I like using it with how do you call it, text. So let me bring in some text. Okay. So this is the size, the font size. So I'll increase it a little to have the font big. Then I can type my font. Add your permission to use your name to type. I don't know if that's how you spell your name though. Okay. I have typed this already. I'm lazy. I won't go back. So I did control T, then I use the Alt. If you are using an older version of Photoshop, then you can use the Shift Alt. But with the latest one, you just use Alt, then you make it bigger. Okay. So somebody asks you to do a backdrop for their wedding, you can do something like this. Then, so the effects are blending options. They are effects that you can apply to your image, text, and any other element. So last time, I think we looked at the color overlay, right? Where when you click on the color overlay, you can go in to change the color, okay, of the text. So when you open it, this is what happens. It brings the dialog box. So you have the color overlay. You can see that it's thick. So I'm using the color overlay. So you can change the color. Now let me pick some of them. I may show all of them, but let me pick some of them. Shadow, drop shadow. You know shadow. When you are walking, you see yourself. So let me now. You see the color overlay. These are the properties. If you just go here, you click on it. If you just click inside it, okay, let me go back. If you just click inside it, you will not see the properties of the shadow. So you have to click on the text itself to be able to see it. So you see the properties of the. So you have the blending mode. That one, you will look at it later, but let it be at where it is. It's on multiply. You can try any of them and see how it is. It's just how the shadow is going to appear. So you can see that the shadow disappears and comes. So let's use the multiply. Now you are going to look at the angle where you want your shadow to come from and the opacity. So opacity is talking about how solid you want it. Okay, I don't know if you can see the shadow, but let me increase the so the size and the distance. Let me use it. So I hope you can see the shadow now. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Can you see the shadow? Okay. And this shadow is saying that it's green. And we don't have a green shadow. So I will send it to the black. So we have a black shadow. Now I wanted to show you the opacity. So I come down, it will become lighter. Okay. Transparency. Okay. So yeah. Distance. Look at distance. Distance. You see, it's pushing it up and then it's pushing it out. Then you have how you want it to. So the spread is too deep. Deep. I bring it down to make it lighter. I just wanted to show like it's a 3D text. Then the size of it. So look at this. You see, the size, it becomes bigger. Distance, I'll bring in the distance so that it doesn't move away from the text. The distance, when you look at it, you see that the shadow has come out. Okay. Then you have the angle where with the direction you want it to push to more. Okay. You see this one is up. It's at minus 72 angle. I think 90 is one of the angles that will give you a uniform. Then quality, how you want, these are what we call contour. So you can select the contour and see the effect. You see how the effect is. It's just to tell you how the thing will shape into it. Okay. But just leave it at the normal contour. We'll look at contour if you have time later, or if you are going to your advanced designs. Okay. So that's how you bring in shadow. Then you have outer glow, so you can put a color there to glow. So outer glow to have opacity. There is a noise and all that. So let me pick a color from here. You can, and then increase it, so you can see the outer glow. Okay, so this way we change the color. You can use a uniform color from here. Okay. Don't be confused though. Once you practice it, you'll see all the effects. I use them sometimes, sometimes I don't use them at all. The pattern, you know of pattern. Pattern, you can select the pattern. Let me take the hand. If the color is there, it won't work. So let me take the color out. So you can select any pattern and then it will have effect on the picture. So you can see those patterns showing inside it. Okay, so that's the patterns that we have available. I think there is a way you can go and add texture and all that. Okay, when you come to the settings here, so you can look at that later. Look at this color, this is a texture, so you can bring in other texture. So let me leave this texture. Then the other one is the gradient that we were looking at. Now, gradient is able to help you to blend two colors together. Okay, so this first one is transparency. And then, see, I can select. So see what I'm selecting, I'll go and change the color. So you see the color is having effect. Green, yeah. I click on the OK. Then I can adjust it to blend into it. So you can see it's moving. So the greater part is this color and then this one is this color. So it blends into it. Yeah, you can also select any of the ones here. Let me click OK and change the angle for you to see. Okay, so you see how it's changing. This need a little practice to know that this is what I wanted. Okay, so gradients, like you are adding so many colors, you can blend two colors together into it, and then you do the angle thing. Okay, there's another thing that I know you guys probably would be interested in, is the bevel emboss. It looks like 3D. Okay, so this is what I'm having. The depth, look at the depth. When I bring in the depth, then I see more of the text. Look at the contour. Look at what is going to happen. See the contour. Okay, so it's slopey, it's undulating and all that. I like using these straight ones. Okay, so it's looking like a 3D. Then you have the inner bevel, so you can make it emboss, as if it's embossed inside your whatever. Then you have the chisel hard and soft. Okay, you can decide not to look at all this. You can do your design without this, but if you want to seriously go into these things, you have to look at it. But I'm just showing you that these are what it does. If you have time, you can look at it later. Then the stroke. The stroke, when you increase the size of the stroke, you see that, yeah. You see that the color is bringing around it. So you can change the color. So probably I want white around it with my shadow. Okay. So that is stroke. Then inner shadow. Let me increase the opacity and see if the. Okay. So this is how the inner shadow looks like. I don't think I've even been using inner shadow and the inner glow. The inner glow is that it's coming from the inside. So I have the size. So you can see it has a little change to, yeah. So because of the red. Then the satin. I increase the opacity. So you see that the black is blending into my design. Let me use red and then increase the opacity. You see it's blended into reach the size. So I mean you can practice it. This takes practice. You will just have to manipulate and see what you want. But I want you to pay attention to the color. That is the color. Okay, the gradient. You can go in. Okay, so I can select this area and select my own color that I want. And then come here. And then, yeah. So let me just pick two colors. Okay, so I picked the other one was transparent. Then I want this place to be yellow. So you select this, the one you see down there. That are the you when you click on it to bring the color. Then you change it. Okay, so I'll click on OK. Then I can go into manipulate to get the angle I want. Now the style, you can do it reflected. It means it's going to be on. You can do it a linear. So you see linear blends. Look at how it blends. Yeah, it's like from one side to the other. Look at the difference. Reflected is like the whole front. Then you have radar, so it's like the middle. So it's coming from the middle. When I increase the angle, it's expanding. Then you have the angle. One side. Then you have diamond. It will look like how the diamond shape is from the middle. So these I can use the blending session to be able to manipulate and change properties of text. You can do the same thing for the shape, rectangle, and all that. But we like using it for text. We want our text to stand up. So this one is looking like it's a 3D text because of the shadow it's having. So yeah, look at I bring down the size and it looks like it's a 2D for me. I know this will be too much to take in, but I mean that's what it is used for. And you have to spend time to practice it yourself. I'll take questions. Mami Ajua, Abigail, who else is here? There is Simon. There is Simon. Simon, you are late. And then Frank. Frank too is late. Is it? I know it will be fast, but I'm just showing you that that's what they use it's used for. So you have to practice. Okay. Yeah, just message me. Yeah. Frank was talking. Is it the Frank I know? Okay. No problem. The video is there. Once you play, you play the video, you pause, you do it, you play, you pause. And you'll be able to do it. One thing about design is that you have to be able to learn it, or else, yeah, and practice. Abigail. Okay, last week I also mentioned that I'll teach you what we call maxing. So maxing is just when you want to do a transparency of any picture or any of the elements on the layer. Okay, so today we'll look at what we call layer masking. Okay, so if I want to do something to a part of an image, there's something we call layer mask that I will use. So probably I want to hide some part of an image or bring it in. Then that's where I'm going to use layer mask. Now I want you to remember this, that black will clean or hide your object, and then white is going to reveal it. Let me take it again. Black will reveal your object or any element within the layer panel, and then white will reveal it. Mami Ajo, I'm on you today. Can you say what I said? I'm saying that black will clean or hide, and then white is going to reveal. Mami Ajua, can you say what I said? Yes. So now that you have said it, you don't have to forget it. Abigail, are you there? I'm saying black will do what? Okay, don't go and hide it. So take it that when you are in darkness, you are hiding, right? You are able to shade yourself. Okay. Now, when you open your Photoshop, you have the colors at this the toolbar section. So you have black. You can see there's black and white. The black is the foreground, and then white is the background. Okay. So if you want to use any of them, one have to be on top. So if I want the white to be at the top, I will just press the X on the keyboard. So you can practice it. Then it will change the color for me. You can see it change. Okay. Now there's this tool down here. When you come to the layer panel, you see down here, we have done almost all of them now. It left with what we call the maxing tool. So layer marks. Now, I want to mask this image, okay? So let me enlarge it a little for you to see. So I want to clean some part of this image. So I will, with my image selected, I click on the layer marks. Now you can see when you click on it, it brings some white box. You can see it. That's the thumbnail. Then the tool I'm going to use is what we call the brush tool. So I'm introducing you to another tool called brush tool. You can use the brush tool to paint. Okay, so this brush tool. So I select it. Now, yeah. Okay. Oh, okay. I'm saying that the layer mask, where you have the FX, the layer style, that is the FX. Then you have layer mask. After that, you have the adjustment. So the layer mask is just down there. So the if you want it to have effect on a particular thing, you select the thing in the layer panel before you go and click on the layer mask. So I click on it, and then you see that it's bring this thumbnail white. So make sure the white thumbnail is the one selected, not the image itself. Then you go and select the tool called brush tool. Okay. Now the brush tool you use, you can increase the size of the brush. So those of you who were drawing when you were in school, so you can have a bigger brush and a smaller brush, or those who do painting. When you right click, you see the size and then the hardness. So hardness, the size, you increase it to increase the size. You can see it has increased. Let me put hardness as 100% for you to see. So if I want to clean this, you see, hardness is sharp. Look at what it has done. It's so sharp. Let me go back, right? Then right click. Bring down the hardness. And then see how. So my hardness is down, and then I'm able to clean, but it's blending into my image. So it's not that sharp. Okay. So there are times people even use this to clean background. So if they reduce their size a little, they use it to blend the background and clean it a little. Yeah. I know some crazy people who have been using that. So they do this. Then when they get into the camera, they will reduce their size too. Sometimes you just want this effect, the white showing around it. So you don't want it to be clean, croppy. Okay, so you can clean all this. So what is black doing? You can see the black is on top. Can you see it? So black is cleaning or hiding the part of your picture. So you can see the picture is intact there, but we put the mask on it to hide it. Now, if I bring white to the front, I can use it to reveal. So I will bring back all that I have done. I'm bringing it back by using the white. Let me increase the size. Okay. Okay. So if I have, let me remove the, so let me say I have this image here like this. Let me draw a background. Let me change the color of the background by double clicking on it to any color. Okay, this is okay. So I'll push it down. Okay, now I'll select the picture and then click on layer marks. Then I'll select the brush tool. Because I want to hide some part of this, I will let the black be on top. Then I'll clean it to blend into it. So there are times we do design like this just to blend the image into it. Okay. So you can have something like this, blending it into it. Okay. Let me draw a black background and then blend it. So this is black. So I was with the black, the rectangle selected, I click on layer mask, select the brush tool. Then I'll now blend it into it. You can increase the size. When you increase the size, the blending becomes more prominent when you want to fade into it. So see what I have done. It's just like the okay. Let me go and pick an image that I can use to illustrate. Okay. Okay, so I'm picking that background. Let me use another background. So I wanted to blend two backgrounds into each other. Let me increase their size. Control T. So this is actually on it. So I'll use the black. So I select the layer mask, you see. Then I select the brush with the black. I'll let the brush be a little bigger. Okay, then I blend this into it. So I have one side of my design with that color and this one. So you can blend backgrounds to create something different. Okay, I'm using this to do a design for someone. Okay, so I can even go around it to let it be at the middle. Okay, so I'm just going around it to blend this into it. Okay, so you can do anything. That background, let me see if I have seen the design I was using it for. It's for some soap design. Okay. So if you look at this design, I went into the thing to export this how do we call them, the ladies know then. Okay, so these are the plates. Okay, so it's separately in it. Then this, okay, I exported this also from the online thing. The liquid soap is a test, and then this is a rectangle. Then you see the lemon. So I also export the lemon as an individual thing, and then bring it in. Firstly, I wanted to use this background. I felt like no, I wanted bubbles, so I looked for this background to use. Yeah. So this is how the design is coming up. Now, if you take the text, for example, let's take lime. When I go to the layer style, you can see that I use stroke, I use color overlay, and I use the shadow. So you see the shadow is making it look like, yeah. Then the overlay is green, and then the stroke is the white around it. Then when you go into fresh, where is fresh? Fresh do I use the same thing. If I were to select bevel, see what will have happened. Okay. But I think I'm cool with my flat design. Then you have this. So designing actually is not anything big. It's just bringing this object from every angle together. Once you know how to arrange them on your layer panel, you are definitely good to go. So I'll be bringing in more tags for us to do arrangement and all that. And then next week we'll look at the website. Okay, we'll look at the website how we can use it. I think those who are doing Saturday will do this training, and then on Sunday, if I'm free on Saturday, they will be able to do the website. Then Tuesday and Thursday, people will also do the website. That's by using Illustrator. I was supposed to eat fufu. I couldn't eat it, so I'll pause it. If you have a question, ask so that I can go and eat. Yeah. Okay, yeah, I'll. The vanishing point. I think I did a video on it and posted on the page. It's 53 megabyte pair. Go and download it. The person who says somebody can go first, no, she cannot come. Yeah. Which one? Yeah, it's I spotted it from somewhere. I cropped it from somewhere. Okay. So you have to know the color and the things you are using. It maybe the cropping. Maybe it's the cropping. This one I didn't crop this. Okay. Yeah, I understand that there are some things when you put it into another bag and it doesn't go well. Not yes, not so it could be other color or it's not well cropped for you to see how it is, and some colors won't go with others. For example, if I'm doing this design, there's no way I'm going to use red or any, I'm not going to use background red because I know it's for washing, and lime is almost like green yellow, right? Yes, so see the lime, the lime. Where is the lime itself? So you see the lime, how it blended in it. You see? Yeah.